Hello guys and welcome back to the Fortune TV Show YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to encourage every Real pioneer who are currently mining Pi coins worldwide. But first I want to share with you something every pioneer should keep in mind. Because if you manage to stick with this video until the end, you'll learn something very important. So here we go. I entered a motel yesterday afternoon. I browsed the menu before placing my order. About 20 minutes later, a number of men and women entered and placed their orders. I'm shocked that these people got served first. They started eating, and I watched as they laughed loudly. One of them was even heard boasting about his connections to everyone at the hotel, which made me feel humiliated. I chose to depart. I phoned the waiter when I could bear it no longer. To stay for long. And he replied to me while saying that mine is a unique order and is being created by the top chef himself, he stated gently. Since the best chefs are preoccupied on your order, students on attachment hastily made their orders. They received first service as a result. Drink some juice while you wait, please. I took a deep breath and held my breath. Six waiters soon brought my dinner to the table. Unbeknownst to me, the hotel's proprietor, who also happened to be a long-lost acquaintance of mine, saw me arrive and decided to surprise me. She transformed my basic dinner into a gourmet one. The individuals at the opposite table were surprised. They stared incessantly. They began to complain and inquire as to why they had not received the type of dinner and service. Such is life. Some individuals have eaten before you and are now laughing at you as they brag about how much better and wiser they are than you. They also claim to be wealthy, connected, well-off, and to be having a good time. You are patiently waiting, wondering why the breakthrough is taking so long. You put up with teasing and attitude. Perhaps you've struggled with depression, severe mental distress, or suicidal thoughts. Not to worry. The creator of the world has observed you and does not desire that you be given a little dinner like those who are mocking you. You have to wait a while since your food is exceptional. Preparation takes time. And only executive chefs cook them. Wait patiently for your supper. When it arrives, the laughing crowd will finally stop. And they will start following your opinions because you had vision. So, guys, without any further delay, give us like, hit subscribe and smash notification icon for future video updates that we release. Now let me talk a little bit about the progress of the Pi Network project so far. In addition, if you haven't seen a KYC message on your Pi mining account home screen, particularly every time you try to mine, you may try going to the Pi browser and tapping on the KYC button to see if one appears. Do this frequently, both during the day and at night. Make sure your ID is current and ready. Additionally, make sure the space is well lit with light for both document capture and selfie taking. Some users have been getting KYC notifications via the Pi browser, however, you have to keep trying it until it works. Keep trying since the core team is working to expedite the KYC procedure. The only method to switch to the mainnet and use your Pi coins is to complete KYC. Alexander, a pioneer, said that during this time, pioneers should accommodate everyone, even if you don't agree with them, in reference to the consensus pricing of Pi. This is a time of trust building, and with each successful transaction, trust is attained. $300 to $314,159 is acceptable. Make sure you support any consensus with a product or service. Increasing consensus also entails offering more products and services to support it. Now you can see why we want our consensus pricing to be as high as Pi equals $314,159, wrote Shepard, another user of the Pi network. If the price of Pi were that low, it may range from $1 to $100 or less. People will use it up rapidly. Consider getting a phone for 1 cent. That's excessive. You would use up all of your Pi in less than a month, and Pi is only used by the wealthy. It won't be as simple to be spent over time when it's thus high though. I take it you're from Tanzania? I want you to convert $314,159 into your native currency and find out what one is worth in your country, or perhaps some other African nation. Then consider how long it would take you to spend $314,159. Or have you spent money up to that amount, $314,159, since the start of this year? Prior to merchants and wealthy people receiving all the pie from settlers, a very long time would pass. We're attempting to explain this to the community, but a lot of people don't get it. Instead, they complain that the cost is too high. And a lot of people just concur with that idea because they want to be really wealthy. The consensus price of one pie equals $314,159 is not about the becoming rich, it's about protecting pioneers from the rich who want to steal pioneers' mine coin in the blink of an eye. It will help pioneers not to quickly spend all their pie, at least it will take a very long while before the rich owns a large share of pie on the network. I'm sure you know that in most crypto project, the people with the highest stake, money, in the project can control it market, price, and value. So, $314,159 will still give the power to the community. There will be no room for the rich folks and whales to hijack Pi and take over the ecosystem. Firstly, mining of Pi will continue even up to the next 50 years. Only challenge would be that mining rate will be too slow. At some point in the future, it will take months to mine up to one Pi. Secondly, we have the liquidity pool where pioneers can always buy pie, so nobody is going to run out of pie. Even merchants will invest in the liquidity pool to make pie available for pioneers to buy, while the merchants will also earn interest for providing liquidity. So, it's two ways to earn money now if you're a merchant. Provide utilities by offering goods and services. And also provide liquidity by staking pie in the pool for traders to trade pie. Thirdly, we have the lockup, which will help pioneers to save more pie and spend less. When the lockup feature was introduced newly, a lot were sad and angry, they didn't really understand the importance of the lockup. Fourthly, exchanges don't run out of crypto. There's got to be exchanges that will always buy and sell pie during the open network. Most people on the exchanges will always take pie to be listed there for trading. This way, people can always buy pie. Many people are not interested in holding pie for a long term. Most people will only buy cheap from pioneers and sell high to another pioneer. Buy again and sell high, the circle repeats and goes round and round. There'll always be pie to buy and sell. Lastly, even if pie is in the hands of the rich, the rich will look for more ways to increase their wealth by listing pie on the exchanges for people go buy at a more expensive, higher rate. The future of pie is bright. People only need to understand and study more about Pi Network. That's just it, education is the thing. Get to know more about Pi and then you'll understand more about why we want to value Pi at a higher rate. Since we want to use Pi as money. We don't want anybody to run out of Pi too soon. At least with the rate being so high, it will take a significant amount of time to spend all your Pi. When you are in the US, you spend the dollar in exchange for goods and services. When you are in Nigeria, you exchange your naira with goods purchased. Same goes for the Ghanaian cedi, the Saudi rials, the Canadian dollars and what have you. Unless you are out of those countries, you won't even need to exchange your money to another currency before you spend it most of the times. Why do you now need to change your pi to a currency before you spend it? Let's encourage one another to utilize this rare opportunity and make the Pi a global currency. At least you don't need to change the Pi to any currency to spend it, since you can easily use it as a means of exchange to buy goods/services. Pi is a global currency, my people, no single government owns it. It's me and you that own the Pi. We are the government, hence the Pi knows no boundaries. Don't be hell-bent on selling the Pi for some other currency. At least this is the essence of this enclosed mainnet and even beyond. The only means of earning the pie should be by either mining it or via trade by barter, as far as the trade by barter is concerned. It's that simple. Value the pie, my people. It's for our own good. And guys, I hope this was enough for today's video. So if you would like to join Pi Network Pioneer, use the link in the description. When they ask for the invitation code, use Aloysmet and it will increase your mining rate. Just remember to subscribe, like, comment, and that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. We love you.